Okay, so hopefully there's a little bit more clarity here as to how this code works after having discussed some of it in class and then also after watching the first three tutorial videos. The objective again is to get this ball to, we'll just simulate a bouncing ball basically. Make sure that we basically can simulate a ball that bounces off of the sides of a screen. And so right now in the current implementation, if I run this, the ball will travel in a direction here and just then stop. And as soon as it stops, there's a delay, a 5 second delay given by this 5,000 milliseconds, and then we quit, which I'll actually make a little smaller, like 1 second right there instead. But again, the implementation here is get the ball to move to the right, and then when it hits the screen, it stops. Now, the reason why it stops is because this condition is not true anymore. Recall that X is the location, the X coordinate of the center of the ball or of the circle. So X and X is changing. We're adding 1 to X every time. Now let's actually try to, well, let's make things a little more as they should. The first thing I want to do here is replace that 10, which is supposed to be the radius of the circle, with the variable. And so I'll make after ball color, so I have screen color. I'll put all the variables that have to do with the ball or the circle right here. I'll make a rad, short for radius, and I'll put it as 10. And now I can come in here and I can replace that with rad. Now I don't expect the radius of my ball here to be changing. It's going to always stay at 10, but it is better to make this a variable because we're going to use the radius of the circle here in our implementation. So I'll come back here and I will look here at this image here because I want us to understand what we're trying to do here. So let me go ahead and do this for a minute. Now, recall here what we have here. We have a window that is 700 700 pixels wide by 400 pixels high, and well, there's a coordinate frame such that the top left corner is at 0, 0, which means that this bottom corner over here would be 700 units to the right, 400 units down. And that was from the previous explanation. So, okay, we have this then, right? I did make it such that roughly every 3 squares is 100 pixels, just to get a little bit of a sense of, well, some scale here, to get some scale. I will draw another circle here, and let me see if I can. Oh, I accidentally erased it. So when we get the circle here in place, what is going on? Okay, so that's not working. Let me do it one more time. Okay, there, that's a little better. So I'll make that circle there, and then I can move it. And I want to place it right here. I'm going to zoom in a little bit because I want to make a few comments here. So the center of the circle is X. So suppose that this is a circle with a radius of 10. You know what? Let me just not make my heart my life here. Let me actually just give it a little bit more size so that it's easier to work with. So I'll just make it like that much, you know? Not a big deal. There. Okay. So I have my circle here where I can then see, okay, well, X, come on. Okay, fine. I keep erasing this. I'm trying to drag it, but okay.
So I have the center of the circle at x, y. That's that point right in the middle of the circle. But the right side of my circle, which would be this side right here, is not at x. It's at x plus the radius, right? That's x plus the radius comma y. That would be this point right here. Right there. That would be that point, which means that x minus the radius would be over here. You know what? That's not a good color here because it doesn't stand out. So this is x plus the radius, comma y. This is x minus the radius, comma y. Now, the reason why I'm interested in this is because we want this to bounce off the edge. And when we have it bounce off the edge of the circle is not at x, y. It is at a slightly different location. If we're also going to have it bounce off the top, then I'm going to need the coordinate here, where that is not x, y is again in the center. So that would be the same x coordinate, but the y would be y minus the radius. So for the top, and I'll start giving these names in a minute. Remember that going down, in this case, you're adding to the radius, going up, you're subtracting. And then finally, the bottom would be x and then y plus the radius. So that would be this right here. Now you have like the location here of the top, bottom, left, and right. And we can give these names here. We can make variables for them. So again, I'll call this, I'll put it on the side, but we'll have to do a variable, write a variable name for it. This is the left. This is the top, and this is the bottom. And why is that important? Is because we don't want the center of the circle to hit the edge. We want the outer boundary of the circle to hit the edge. And so I'm going to make some variables here where I'm going to come in to my code. And I'm going to make the variables, I'm just going to write them down. They're not necessarily going to be used at this place, but I do want to write them down here. So I have right equals. I said that's x minus, plus the radius, comma y. And then the left side of the circle is x minus the radius, comma y. And then the top is x minus the radius. Oh, excuse me. It's x comma y minus the radius. And then finally the bottom, which I'll just write bot, is x and then y plus the radius. Good. Now, why is this important here? I want to simulate the ball bouncing off the edge. Now I'm going to do this for one edge, and your job then is to make it bounce off the other edges. So I have a ball that's moving to the right. Notice how it's moving to the right. How do I get it to move once it hits the right boundary? How do I get it to move to the left? That's the question. Okay, so I have these variables here that are correspond to the location of where the ball's boundaries are at. Right, left, top, and bottom boundaries. So I'm going to come into my while loop, and I'm going to say that if the right boundary, which is this location right here, if the right boundary, which is given by a coordinate, but more specifically, I am interested in only the x coordinate of the right boundary, which it would be x plus the radius. So that corresponds to this right here, that little dot,
on the right side of the circle, this orange or yellow dot, if that value is greater than 700 or equal to, so that means I've hit, this point has gone past this green line. If it's greater than 700 or equal to 700, greater than or equal to 700, but I don't want to hard code the 700. Instead, I want to use the variable w, because that is set to 700 up here, w 700. So then if that is true, I've hit the ball, has collided with the right boundary, meaning the right boundary, the right edge of the screen. And what I want to do is I don't want to be adding, right here I'm adding 1 to x every time. And when I add 1 to x, I want, I'm moving my center of the circle to the right, 1 unit and 1 unit, because increasing x moves it to the right. Remember, x is the x location of the center. And so what I want to do, I'm going to make a variable here that I'm going to call delta x. Delta is used a lot when we're trying to say that, like, we're just making it, we're adding a small quantity to x. I'm calling it x because I'm adding it to x. So delta x, I'm going to say that delta x is going to start off at 1. Notice that I'm initializing it up here, and I'm putting it with all the other variables that have to do with the ball. So delta x is what I'm adding. So I'm adding 1 to x every time. That moves my circle to the right because I'm increasing the x coordinate. But when I get too far, that when the variable, the right side of my ball is greater than or equal to the width, that means I've gone too far to the right, then I'm going to say that delta, I'm going to change delta x. And I'm going to say delta x is what it used to be times negative 1. So it's just basically going to make it negative. If it's 1, negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. But the reason I want to multiply is because then I might hit the left edge and I would want to change it back to positive. And well, that's your job though. And now, let's notice what happens. It bounced. Now it doesn't bounce off this edge, because I have encoded that. That's going to be your job, and have it also bounce off the top and the bottom edge. And the implementation, by the way, this is running still because this condition is true now forever. X is always going to be less than 700 because it's going further and further to the left. So I'm going to restart my Python shell so that I can end that run. So then we need to start thinking, okay, well, what condition do we want here instead? Because obviously it's going on forever. So we need to figure out a way to terminate our code here. And it's okay if we figure that out later. That is fine. It's okay if it's not, if it's still doing this. What we can do is we can just make an infinite loop by putting here while true. I need to capitalize the T. And true is always going to be true. It's never going to change. So this is an infinite loop and it's going to run forever. And that's okay. We can just restart the Python shell. But notice how it bounces off the right edge. And it goes on forever. It doesn't bounce off this left edge because I haven't coded that. Your job is to code that. And you would have to replicate some of what I have here, along with the fact that x is x plus delta x. I don't have the code for the y motion going up and down, but this makes it bounce off the right edge. So making it bounce off the left edge would be very similar. There would be some changes here, some differences, and making it bounce off the top and bottom edge would also be very similar, but instead of x, you'd be dealing with y. Now this right here I wrote to give you a little bit of understanding of where it's coming from, but I don't really need this anymore. I took what I wanted. This is what I was interested in. The x coordinate of the right edge of my ball, so I can actually delete it. Now you're going to have to use some of this in your if statements and your implementation. That again is your job. So that's your next job too. I've made it so that it bounces off the right edge. I want you to make it so that it bounces off of any edge, top, bottom, left, and right. Notice how it says it's not responding and it takes a while. That's why I suggest you just restart the Python shell. Alrighty, that's your assignment.